How to apply gradients using brushstrokes in Affinity Photo. Create a document the same size as the current document. So File and New. I'm going for 1783 and 1178. Click Create. Go to Layer menu and New Layer. You need a layer for the gradient. Go to the Gradient tool and apply a basic gradient. You can also apply new ones using the swatches panel. However, sources. Go to the sources panel. You can find that in the view menu, studio and sources. Go down to the bottom and you can see here, little add global source. And you've now got one source. Go to the swatches panel, again, view menu and studio, and click and create another gradient. And again, sources, and just add that one as well. Now you could add 15, 20 different sources. I'm just going with two. Now at this point, let's go back to the original image. Go to the clone brush tool in the tools panel, then go over here to the sources panel. You need to define a reference point in these. So just go there and double click. You can see the cursor change. Just simply click there to define a source reference point. Go to that one, the second one, double click that and do exactly the same. It doesn't have to be top left. It could be any position here. Click and now you've got your reference point. You can see a little dot in the sources. Then go to the brushes and then select one of the brushes. I'm using textures. You can use any of the other brushes. So just select that one, set the width, opacity, all those settings, as well as blend modes, normal, darken, multiply, etc. Go for aligned. Go for global. And also at this point, 0 and 100 for the scale and apply. And I'm using the, go here, the second one. And you can see now you've got your gradient applied. Select different brushes in the brush panel. As well as changing the brush, you can move backwards and forwards between the sources. If I've got 10 or 15 sources, you could see a lot more variety. I'm going to go with the first one and apply. And you can see you've got that grayscale gradient. You can simply then select the second one and apply that as well. And you can see you just add it and combine them in many different combinations. Of course, if there were many more sources. Vary the blending mode. I've got normal here. I'm going to go with darken and then apply. And you can see a colourful design there. Well, you can also go to multiply and apply it that way. Or lighten. Variety of different designs can be created just by changing this blending mode. Go with difference. And you can apply it multiple times with different blending modes. You can also go to opacity. Just change that. Set it to 45, 50. Just reduce it down a bit. Doesn't need to be 100%.